myself Mani Saxena. Part 1 I have already taught you, 9th class. Now part 2 I am taking now. We have stopped on which topic? About the atmosphere. Till 3 layers we have done, that is realms of the earth. That is which layers? That is hydrosphere we have taken, lithosphere and atmosphere realms we have taken. Now we are talking about the atmosphere. 4 layers are there. This is, we have stopped over here. It consists of 4 layers. First is troposphere. What is troposphere? Which is the lowermost layer in which we live. Lowermost layer in which we live. All weather phenomena that affect our life directly take place within the troposphere. It extends to about 8 km at the poles and about 16 km at the equator. Now the next layer is, that is stratosphere. What is the stratosphere? That over here temperatures does not change with altitude. It is free of water vapor and dust. Stratosphere consists of the ozone layer. It absorbs the burning ultraviolet rays from the sun. This layer protects us from these harmful rays from the sun. The presence of this layer is a boon of human beings. Now the next layer is, that is ionosphere. What is ionosphere? The ionization of molecules and atoms occurs mainly as a result of UV, X-rays and gamma rays. Now the next layer is, that is exosphere. What is exosphere? Which is the outermost layer of the atmosphere. It forms the outermost boundary of our atmosphere. The atmosphere is a region is highly predominant with rarefied hydrogen and helium gases. Now tell much over here we have covered it about the atmosphere, 4 layers. Okay, now the next topic we are starting in this only, Earth as a unique planet, shape and size of the Earth. Now we are talking about the shape and size of the Earth, means people in, what is the over here, people in ancient time, there was a misconception was there ki they are saying ki that Earth was a flat table, but we are saying, we already know, but in now the over in the present age we are saying ki that Earth is spherical in shape. They are thought that after reaching the, means they are Earth shape was an after reaching to, when they thought that after reaching the steep edge of the table, they would, if it is a flat table is there, then they can easily slip down into the ocean, they are saying. They thought after reaching the steep edge of the, they would slip down into the ocean. Even the great navigators has come, that is Christopher Columbus, has difficulty has collecting his views over there during this expedition. What is the expedition? That it was a flat table. The next scientist has come, that is about the, that is Magellan Fernandez. He has taken the world round of this in 1519. He has taken. It was proved beyond doubt that Earth was round in shape. Now in the present space stage, we are saying that Earth is spherical in shape, and it's established fact and has been proved and accepted by all, that is ki Earth is spherical in shape. Earth shape is described as oblate spheroid. We have given the word is oblate spheroid, right? And its meaning is perfect sphere. Appears to be a perfect, it's not so. The measurements of our Earth at the equator and slightly blows and show it's a slightly bulge, means it's slightly bulging. Bulging means round at the equator and the flattened at the poles. That's why it means the round at the equator diagram, you know only, and flattened at the pole. That's why saying ki Earth is spherical in shape, not in round or a flat table. The Earth is shaped like an orange, slightly flattened at the pole with a bulge at the equator, and it is also called a geoid. We have given the name, we have given oblate, described geoid, we have given a word which means labium, means Earth shape, means geoid, means Earth shape. This is the shape and size of the Earth. Now what is the main, you all know that Earth is spherical in shape in the present space age. Now the next topic we are talking about, the proofs of the Earth shape, means some proofs are also there ki means if Earth was a not flat table, there's a misconception is now which type a spherical. What are the proof ki Earth is spherical in shape? Why we are saying ki Earth is spherical only? First is, that is proved is all celestial bodies are spherical. What are celestial bodies? That is sun, moon, satellites, asteroids. These, they are spherical. स्पाइरिकल इन शेप, दैट्स व्हाई वी आर सेइंग कि अर्थ शेप इज स्पाइरिकल. Spheres are the only geometrical shapes that are circular in outline. Sun, moon and all other celestial bodies appears to be of circular outline. Since Earth too belongs to the same system, there is no reason why Earth should be an exception. That's why Earth is spherical in shape. Now the second proof is that is circumnavigation of the Earth. In this wished example, we are taking Magellan example, that is Ferdinand Magellan, who has taken the world round. From the starting point, he has traveling round in the world and came back to the same point. He has starting point and again came back to the same point. That's why Earth is spherical in shape. Now the line of visibility increases with height. How we have been explained? If we are saying ki earth, if earth was a flat table, then we can have, I take the example of over here of a ship. I have taken the example. If earth was a flat table, then we can see the whole ship at one time. But earth is spherical in shape. That's why we are saying, the ship part, first part we are saying the one time, next part we are saying one time, and next part we are saying another. So different time we are saying. So that's why earth is spherical in shape. An observer standing on a cliff sees the mass on the approaching ship, and then its funnel, lastly the hull. If earth were flat, he would well see the whole ship at one time. Now the next proof is that is sunrise and sunset. We already know that sunrise in the east and sets in the west. If earth was a flat table, then the sun would rise and set at the same time for all the people in the world. But the time varies all over the world. This is due to round shape of the earth. Now the next proof is that is aerial photograph. What is aerial photograph? When we are taking the photograph from the satellites, that is called aerial photographs. Sent by artificial, the aerial photographs of the earth sent by artificial satellites and various spacecraft clearly show the curvature, means clearly show the outline of the earth's surface. Picture of the earth taken from the surface by the astronaut clearly proves the sphericity or the spherical shape of the earth. Now these are the proofs of the earth shape. Please read it thoroughly from the book. Now that you all are having a book also, please, what are the examples, what are the diagrams are drawn, learn it thoroughly, class 9. Now the next topic we are talking about in this only, earth as a humankind and conditions that exist here. The earth is the fifth largest planet and the third nearest planet to the sun. Why it is unique? Because it is the only planet in the solar system where life is known to exist. What are the favorable conditions are also over here? Favorable conditions that promote life on earth as follows. First is distribution of land and water. Talking also, we have talked about also, what is the distribution of? Get 71% covered with water and 29% of land. And thus, the distribution of land and water is uneven. In the northern hemisphere, the areas of land and water are nearly equal. Whereas in southern hemisphere, there is nearly 15 times as much water as land. Next is that is antipodal. The second topic about is why antipodal. What is antipodal? Arrangement of land and water. If you see the world map, then you can see one side is land and other side is water is given. That's why we are taking the world, we are taking one land and water, antipodal. One side land, other side water. One side land, other side water. One side land, other side water. Means opposite side. That's why we are taking the word antipodal, arrangements of land and water. The greatest land masses form an almost complete girdle in the northern hemisphere. The land mass are narrowest in the southern hemisphere. Now the second favorable condition, that is why earth we are having a life on it, because of suitable temperature, suitable atmosphere and suitable water cycle or life. Or you already know, life cannot exist without water. Besides its favorable conditions, earth water cycle is most unique feature. Life cannot exist. Life cannot, this is a main part, ki life cannot exist without water. These are the full topic. I cover it in two parts, class. Part 1 also and part 2. Is it clear? One thing more also, if you have purchased the book, please class, the which are terms are given in your book, that you also you have to prepare for your exam only. Some assignment questions also giving over here, and which you have having a book, then some more questions are there, that also you prepare it class. And these questions you have to do it in your copy. First question is, why is earth called a watery planet? Explain. Name the various realms of the earth. State the conditions favorable for life to exist on earth. These three questions you have to do it. And whatever the that and one question also that you have to do, that is, what are the proofs of the earth shape? This also you have to do it class. And if you are having a book, see from the book, what are the proofs of the earth shape? You have to explain it with diagram. Class, you have to explain it with diagram. What are the proofs of earth shape? I'm dictating only. What are the proofs of the earth shape with diagram? Means diagrams you have to make it also in the notebook. These questions you have to do it. Thank you, class.